Welcome to Abipedia 2016's mains question answer discussion. Today's next question is, what does the term BEPS recently in news signify? How has it affected the current fiscal policy of the government? So sir, what is BEPS?
Sir, BEPS stands for base erosion and profit shifting.
Okay.
Now this term was first used by a report prepared by OECD.
Okay, what is OECD?
OECD stands for Organization of Economic Cooperation and Development.
Okay.
It is a consortium of developed nations of the world.
Okay.
Now they had come out with this report.
Okay.
In context of 2008 financial crisis that had rattled the financial markets world over.
Okay.
Now in that report, that stated that MNCs that operate globally, they would either underreport their profit margins or overreport their losses in order to avoid payment of taxes. Now, this payment of taxes would cause loss of revenue to sovereign governments.
Because there are many loopholes in double taxation treaties.
Especially in relation to transfer pricing issues.
Okay.
So transfer pricing is an issue wherein...
What exactly is transfer pricing?
Sir, transfer pricing is an issue
wherein
the parent company transfers certain amount of funds or sells assets to its subsidiary, but at a lower rate.
Okay.
So that a lower rate attracts a lesser rate of tax in the host country where that subsidiary is located.
Okay.
So this these transactions would be in billions of dollars.
Okay.
Now when even if 20% tax rate is applied to billions of dollars, that comes out to be a huge amount.
Yeah.
So sovereign governments would incur a lot of tax loss.
All right.
Now retrospective taxation is allowed.
Mm-hmm.
Now an Indian government asked Vodafone, which is a UK based company, to pay taxes on its transfer pricing issues, on its funds that it transferred to its parent company back
in. Vodafone.
Yeah.
Yes,
that's a separate issue.
Okay.
When Vodafone acquired Hutch
capital gains wala aspect.
Both are foreign companies.
Okay.
But then since they are located in India with permanent establishments and management, Indians on their management board, they were legally bound to pay tax.
Okay.
But then they avoided tax.
Okay. So coming back to the question, sir, I mean, right now there are two parts. One, they're asking what is BEPS. So, okay, we have done with the base erosion and profit shifting system. That is BEPS. So that's a particular kind of enlightenment document, we can say, by the OECD nations, that such kind of behavior can be done by MNCs, and that can lead to tax revenue loss by the for the state governments or sovereign governments. So how is it affecting the current fiscal policy of the government?
Sir, when these big MNCs pay tax, their tax amount is in billions of dollars. So that billion of dollars accounts for a major proportion of government's taxes, direct taxes, corporate taxes, because corporate tax goes directly to central government. Now, if
I would like to contribute one thing, sir. See, in 2016 budget, I heard of an equalization levy. Yes. So it was being much touted as the first endeavor by any country to move forward in the BEPS regime or in the BEPS model. So equalization levy of 6% was applied on the, I guess, internet ads which are given to the Google, Facebook and all these things. So here also these are MNCs and they operate on a lot of profits. Like when we open Facebook page, we see an ad on the side and they give Indian traders. तो उसके ऊपर हमारी गवर्नमेंट को कोई टैक्स मिलता ही नहीं जो भी इनकम होते हैं वो अपना ले जाते हैं सो आई गेस दिस इज द फर्स्ट मूव इक्वलाइजेशन लेवी
यस
कोई और भी इंडियन गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से यहां पे कुछ हुआ है
आई फील द गवर्नमेंट हैज रिसेंटली कम आउट विद मॉरिशस डबल टैक्सेशन और अवॉइडेंस एग्रीमेंट
ओके
Wherein it had mandated that transactions being held of securities being bought after 1st April 2017, listed securities would be subjected to 7.5% tax, whereas unlisted at 20%.
Okay.
So that is another parameter of this agreement.
Okay. So you're trying to refine the double taxation treaties also.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. That should do it. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.